This is Dwayne Friend with University of Illinois Extension. Thunderstorms have several potential hazards, including wind, lightning, heavy rain, tornadoes, and hail. Hail is formed through two processes which create layers within the hailstone. Strong updrafts, which are rising streams of air, in some thunderstorms pushes rain and ice pellets high into a thunderstorm, keeping them suspended within the storm. In this area, both ice pellets and water droplets are found. Temperatures in this area are below freezing, but due to atmospheric conditions, water droplets can remain in liquid form. However, once an ice pellet comes into contact with a water droplet, the water begins to freeze. If the water freezes slowly, it creates a layer of clear ice. If freezing occurs quickly, the ice is cloudy due to a lot of air bubbles being trapped in the ice. If you examine a hailstone, you may be able to see layers of clear and cloudy ice. The hailstone may fall out of the updraft, but then get pulled back in and carried up again. This may happen several times, making the hailstone grow larger each time. The longer a strong updraft is present, the bigger the hailstone may become. Eventually, the hailstone becomes too large to suspend in the air, or the updraft weakens, allowing the hailstones to fall to earth. Small hail does not take strong updrafts to be formed. For example, pea-sized hail can form with updrafts of only 24 miles per hour. Very large hailstones require much stronger winds. Softball-sized hail would need an updraft of 103 miles per hour.